Hello, myself Sumit, and today we are going to learn about how to configure self-hosted agent for Azure DevOps Pipeline. Any on-prem, cloud, machine or a virtual machine can be configured as a agent so that Azure DevOps Pipeline execution can run on it. I will be following this article which has step-by-step procedure to configure the agent. So first, if you see here, we have some prerequisites. So before proceeding further, we should have the Azure DevOps organization detail and also the machine or a virtual machine. So in this case, I'll be using my own system. So I have that details already. And then second is like a DevOps organization. So I have already connected to it under the test 0103. So this is my organization. So step one says you have to log into the Azure DevOps organization, and under the organization setting, navigate to the agent pools. So right now I am on test 0103 organization, and top on the down, if you see here, we have organization settings. I'll click on it and I'll go to the agent pools. Step three says select the existing pool, or you can create a new pool. So if you want to configure the agent, you should be basically creating under a specific pool. So either you can use your existing agent pool, or maybe you can create one. So in my case, I'll add a new pool. So I'll keep the type as a self-hosted, and I'll name it as a custom agent. Now I'll create it. So once you hit add, you can see the new agent pool has been created. Now under the pool, click on the new agent and download the package for the respective operating system. So in my case, I'll pick Windows because I'm going to configure my Windows machine to an agent. So I'll click here and I'll go to the agent. Here, if you see, we do not have any agent currently configured. So I'll just click on the new agent. So we have a Windows, macOS and Linux, three different operating system. And if you are selecting Windows, you just download the Windows, or if you are going to configure your macOS as agent, you can download this package. Similarly with the Linux also. So since my machine is a Windows, I have already downloaded this package. Step 5 says once package downloaded, move the file to the machine where you want to configure the agent. So since I am going to configure my own system, so I have already moved that folder here. Extract the package and you will see the config.cmd file. Yes, I can see the config.cmd file here. Run the command prompt as admin and invoke the config.cmd file. So I will be running the cmd as admin. And I'll be changing the respective directory. So this is the package directory. And I'll invoke the config.cmd. So it is asking for the server URL. So let's go to the article and enter the server URL. URL of the Azure DevOps with the organization. So in our case, we are under the test 0103 organization. So I'll copy until the organization name and put it here. So enter the authentication type. Press enter for PAT. So I'll just hit enter. So we'll create now a personal access token. To create personal access token, we need to go to our user setting, and under that you will have a personal access token with the full access. We'll create it. So I'll go to the user setting. You can see on the top right corner there is a user setting, and then you have a personal access token. So I'll create a new called demo key, and I'll give a full access. So once it is created, you can see you can copy the secret from here. So I have already copied, and now I'll go and paste it here. So now it is connected to our Azure DevOps. Now it is asking under which agent pool you are going to create this agent. So So I'll just say the custom agent. So that is the pool which we created, and further it is asking for agent name. So I'll just give the demo self hosted. So you can just give as per your name. So meanwhile it is running into a work folder. So work folder is something where all your execution will happen. So right now if I see, if I have to give this location as a work location, I'll give this work and I'll copy this path and put it here. So now next is enter run agent as a service. So we'll use the default one, yes, and then this one also will use the default. So just we need to press enter. So now you can see here it is successfully configured. So we'll go to the our article now. So step 9 is there completed, step 10 is already completed, step 11 is also completed. Now on successful configuration, you can see the agent is online in the respective pool under the project setting of Azure DevOps Organization. So we'll go to the agent, and now here you see this agent is configured now. So now our Azure DevOps pipeline is connected to my Windows machine, which, and you can see it is currently online. Okay. Okay, so that's all. So now if you have any issue during your configuration, you can leave your comment here. We'll be happy to help you. Thanks for watching this video, and if it is helpful, kindly like the video. Thank you.